Hello YouTube, today we're gonna do Good Love Is On The Way by John Mayer. It was only featured on like two live albums, so it's a song that was only performed live with the John Mayer trio. Somebody suggested this lesson to me, so shoutouts to someone, I don't really know the name right now. And my version is gonna be based on the Where The Light Is version, because that's the one I've been listening to for like the last years. So yeah, check out my Instagram if you want, I'm gonna link it in the description, it's a really cool place. Let's get into the lesson. Okay, since we're based on Where The Light Is right now, we're gonna start off with the intro he does. The song is in A, and everything is like basically just a normal pop rock song in A. It's on the A chord. And what he does is, he bends the E string on the third. When he does that little singing intro. G in the bass, then he goes to D, not playing the high E string, then to an F, with the 9 down here, or the 2, and a sus2, so the 3rd is suspended for the 2nd, and we're gonna leave it open, like Hendrix always does. So. D with the F sharp in the bass. So we had. And from that he jumps into the rhythm intro. Now let's go through the rhythm intro part only, this one. I think there are like a million ways to play this, but the key is to make use of the open strings. So what am I doing? It's A to G. I'm doing this. That's the first one on the fourth, on the D, on the A string, sorry. And then it's like hammer on, pull off. And then we play the D string on the fourth. And the open G. String on the fifth. And then we just do pull offs, D second, and again the A on the fourth. Do the same thing again. Practice it really slow and you should get around it pretty quick, so. So implemented in my head that if I think about what I play, it doesn't work. I remember when I first played it, I played it like this, without strumming. But it's not so cool, just do it like this. Slowly. discuss the verse strumming. After the like riffing intro that we just did, he goes into strumming and singing, which is the verse for now. And it's again just A to G. Everything's played palm muted, that means that your palm lasts on the strings slightly, so that they don't ring out fully. Just get the basics down. That's what you're looking for now. When you get that down, you can add like little licks in there that he does. He always hammers on the A, I just realized that while watching it. It's the same thing for the whole song. Make use of the open strings, like after every verse he, when he's on the last G, he does like some open licks. Yeah, it is the chorus. We're gonna do that next. In case you're wondering why I play everything clean right now, I suggest you, or I advise you, to always practice everything with a clean tone, because if you sound good in an overdriven tone, you're not always gonna sound good in a clean tone. But if you sound good in a clean tone, you're always gonna sound good in a drive tone. Just a little hint. So, the chorus. Starts off like this. It's a D with an F sharp in the bass. And then the bass switches to a G. Two notes. It's just the G string on the fourth and the B string on the third. Take your normal A chord and you hammer them on. Then you slide up to a normal A. But you only have these two notes. The third and the fifth. Go back down and do this little pull off, or you play two notes, you can do whatever you want on the D string from fourth to second. So again, the chorus. Mm-hmm. this point, make sure that you don't play this note. Before you did, it was just a normal part of the A chord. The fifth right here. But if you would do it here, you would have an A6, and it doesn't really suit the normal major mode we're going for, so... Here, just play these two notes. Otherwise, you'd have an A6. Jokes. And after you completed that, you go back to the second verse. Same thing as before. Just make up licks and make use of the open strings, make it sound good. There's like one more part and another one we're gonna go through these next. Let's do the little thing that they do before they go into the solo, after like the second chorus, or I don't really know, just listen to it. There will be a little in-between part before he does the solo, and it goes as follows. Taking this, it's basically the D, but also we've seen as a G, G major 7, or a sus, but we're gonna do this. You take your first finger and you put it on all the strings except for the E string on the 7th fret, and you're gonna play the A, D, and G string. What you're doing is you have that bass and it goes from 10 to 9 to 7 on the A string. Then the A string on the 5th, and then E, 2, and 3. Almost everything you need. And the fourth time, do it again. And then you land an E. And then he jumps to the solo. A little add-on to the part we did before, like this. Sometimes he just does... here. Sometimes he doesn't follow the single notes. And for the last part, he sometimes does. Strum the open G chord twice. The solo he does, we're not going to do the solo. If you want to have that note for note solo, listen to the song, transcribe it yourself. You're going to learn much more than if you just watch me, like, play it. It's basically only the BB box. And some pentatonic. And he switches between those. He uses a wah-wah pedal. And if you want to get into that, transcribe it yourself. Don't look for lessons. Just transcribe it. Use your ear and be creative, and you're gonna get around pretty quick. After the solo, he does one more chorus. This time, he does it up here. We're outlining the D. Thank you. we're doing is this. Imagine you have a D, and you suspend the third for the two, so you get a sus2 chord. Suspended second, suspended third. Then we do this. And then we do an A sus4. Again, we have the third here, this note, and we just hammer on to this note, the D. Do down here. And then again. Then he does the chorus a few more times and like throws some licks in between. Just pentatonic and BB box stuff. And I think they end the song with doing the this part again. Let me check real quick. Yeah, they just do this part again. And they end on this and he just does some noodling. The usual stuff, so this time you repeat it like quicker, you don't play the A chord in between. A couple of times and try to make your own cool version out of it. I hope it helped you, I hope you enjoyed it. We're gonna do like loads of more lessons in the near future. I have that list. If you want to keep up with everything that I do, check out my Instagram too, and you can write me there. You can suggest licks and lessons and everything. Yeah, it's pretty dope. I'll link in the description. Thanks for tuning in. I hope you learned a lot, and see you next time.